Thank you for choosing Chosen for Another View. And today we are talking with our very own highly anointed co-host, Maria Leyva. And Maria, you have a beautiful dance ministry. What is the name of your dance ministry?
It's Danza por el Rey, which in translated English is Dancing for the Kings.
Beautiful, beautiful. And I had a chance to see you guys dance. You have an awesome, awesome ministry.
Thank you.
And explain to us in detail what each movement means.
Well, the first step means victory. And of course, God always has the victory in this place. So you do a V formation, and that is what victory means. The second step is cleaning the atmosphere. You want to get rid of anything that is unclean, any type of, you know, emotions, disagreements, things like that. You want to push them aside. And as you notice in this movement, what is being done is that it's lowered down to the ground because that's where the devil's at. The devil is underneath our feet. Yes. So we push it down to the side away from us. And then the second one, of course, is you want to rebuke the enemies to make sure that once they are gone, they stay gone and they don't come back. And the next step would be to recognize the kings of kings. And it's important to do that because you have to give God glory. You have to give him honor. And so by doing that, you lift your hands way up into the air to the heavens because that is where he is at. He's not down below, but up in the air.
Beautiful.
And then the sixth step is to reverence and honor and to glory God. And that's by bowing down. That's a point of where you're humbling yourself. And then you lift up because you're humbling yourself to God. And so you have to give glory to God. You have to honor him for humbling you at this point of the spiritual warfare dance. And then the second step, or the seventh step, of course, is to free the captives from the right side. And basically by hopping and removing them, of course, like I said before, they're beneath your feet. So you have to remove them out of your feet and get them out
get
as
them,
well.
Get them out of the way.
Yeah. Amen. And then the eighth one is keeping the enemies out. Again, when you rebuke them, you want them out and away. And that's important. You want to keep cleaning the atmosphere. You don't want anything coming in. If you're doing a dance or a praise or warfare and there are people talking in a congregation and causing division while you're doing that, you got to keep cleaning. You got to keep rebuking. You got to keep going with that and have the people repent at the same time in doing that. And then, of course, the ninth step is to celebrate the victory, and that's by walking around in circles because you're celebrating, you have completed it. God is a God of whole, and that is a completed circle. So you walk in circle in a V formation showing that it is victory.
Beautiful.
And then the 10th step is to tell the north, the south, the east, and the west not to have any fear and that God is with them in those places.
I love it.
And then the 11th step is do not have any fear because, of course, God is with them again. And that is swinging mid-level and showing a figure eight, of course. And then the 12th step is to celebrate that God is with us. And that's by kind of bouncing across the stage with a little twirl because we're celebrating. We're excited. We praised God for him being with us. And then, of course, the 13th step is the presence of God, which raising your hands up into a circle, twirling around and around and around because you want the Holy Spirit
just
to be there.
Beautiful. And the Lord taught you all of that. Oh, that is so awesome. Mm-hmm. I believe you're really helping a lot of our viewers today, especially churches. And I pray that they'll be able to take this instructions into their dance teams in order to get, you know, their church cleaned and revived so that the Spirit of the Lord can reign there.
The first step is victory. The second step is cleaning the atmosphere. The third step is to disarm the enemies. The fourth step is to move the enemies out. The fifth step is to recognize he is kings of kings. The sixth step is to reverence, honor, and glory to God. The seventh step is to free the captives. The eighth step is keeping the enemies out. The ninth step is celebrate the victory. The tenth step is to tell the north, the south, the east, the west, not to have fear. The 11th step, do not have fear, for God is with us. The 12th step is to celebrate that God is with us. And the 13th step is the presence of God.
¿Cuántos saben que Jesucristo es varón de guerra? Y Él desarma a nuestros enemigos. ¡Aleluya!
Varón de guerra, desarmando a sus enemigos, desechando las fuerzas del infierno. Él es Señor y Rey, liberando del infierno. Él es Señor y Rey. Jesucristo es varón de guerra, desarmando a sus enemigos, desechando las fuerzas del infierno. Él es Señor y Rey, liberando a todo cautivo. En su nombre huye el enemigo, ha ganado una gran victoria.
Y Él desarma a nuestros enemigos. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? Digámoslo todos.
Jesucristo es varón de guerra, desarmando a sus enemigos, desechando las fuerzas del infierno. Él es Señor y Rey. Jesucristo es varón de guerra, desarmando a sus enemigos, desechando las fuerzas del infierno.
Yo soy varón de guerra. temas, confía en el Señor. Vamos todos a decirlo.
No temas, estoy contigo, no temas. Yo estoy contigo, no temas. Yo estoy contigo, yo soy varón de guerra. No temas, estoy contigo, no temas. Yo estoy contigo, no temas. Yo estoy contigo, yo soy varón de guerra.
Gózate delante de su presencia. Digno eres, Señor. Santo eres, Señor.